Chroma keying is a matting process in which a specific color, in our case blue, is electronically dialed out of a video picture and replaced with another. This technique has obvious applications for newscasts, instructional programs, and video art. Using two cameras and the video switcher, this effect can be produced here at Nashville Tech. Camera 2, which is set up for chroma keying, detects the color blue and sends it to the switcher to be dialed out. The remaining picture is then combined with another camera to get a composite picture. This is, however, a time-consuming process. Lighting is the most important thing to your subject and its background. Both must be lit evenly, but not too brightly. When choosing a subject, you should use one that is not glossy surfaced. Glossy surfaces tend to reflect unwanted light and make for an unrealistic shot. The brighter the subject's color, the better it will key out. But make sure there aren't any blues on your subject, because it too will key out. As for the subject background, blue chroma key paper works best as it is designed specifically for this purpose. Again, it must be lit evenly and not too brightly. Beware of shadows on the blue background from the subject. The background shot, that is the one that will be electronically produced in the switcher, is simply accomplished. The only problem here is getting the subject and this background to appear realistic. The direction and amount of light will have a direct bearing on the outcome. After choosing and setting up all of these, go to the switcher, assuming that you are using two cameras. Punch up cameras 1 and 2 on Mix Effects 2, and make sure you have a well-lighted picture on the monitor. Then punch up the blue button labeled 2 beneath Mix Effects 2. This selects which camera is to be keyed. Then punch up CK for chroma key and key next to Mix Effects 2. Using the clip control, camera 2's iris control, and its three chroma key controls, you will be able to produce a chroma key effect. Once you have a sharp edge on your subject, which is a task in itself, the possibilities are endless. Even inanimate objects with careful and clever camera work, using zooms, pans, tilts, and even trucks on both subject and background, make for an impressive illusion of movement. Remember that time is of the essence, and patience is a virtue. With this in mind, you should be able to produce something well worth your while.